Stay tuned now for the informative program Insight.
Welcome to Insight. Focusing on issues of importance to North Central Ohio, Insight is a weekly public affairs program of your North Central Ohio Clear Channel radio stations. Now here is your host for this week's program.
Gene Davis here. We're joined in the studio by Ray Herbst from the Ashland County City Health Department. Ray is Director of Public Health Awareness and Education, also Director of the Ashland County City Medical Reserve Corps. Ray, good to have you with us.
Good to be here, Gene.
All right. We're going to talk a little bit as we head into late fall and winter about personal and family safety preparedness. This is the time of year, Ray, when you don't want to let your pride get in your way of your safety, right?
That's correct. You know, as we prepare, as we should prepare year-round, you know, we pride ourselves on our ability to do things and subsequently save ourselves. But, you know, as we go through power outages and different weather events, the key to success is acknowledging you will need the help of others. You will need to allow them to help you. Mm-hmm. So
it's good to have a family plan in place, because it seems like there are very few winters that we go through without some sort of power interruption or just a general situation where you can't get around for a few days, right?
Yes, anywhere from a few days to like 5 days or so. Mm-hmm. Generally, we advise prepare for a three-day period. Okay. And basically, I'd advise that people plan to store an extra charged battery for their cell phone. Of course, drinking water becomes very important. And one of the things I was thinking about before the program was that You could store 3 1-gallon jugs of drinking water for each member of the family, and with the understanding that children and nursing mothers and ill family members need more. However, in case you don't want to store drinking water, that you could plan to use the water that's already stored in the hot water tank.
Mm-hmm.
So some people don't really think about that, but that is an option. And then, of course, we go to storing a non-perishable food that requires no refrigeration, preparation, or cooking. Mm-hmm. And with that, having ready-to-eat canned meats, dried meats, peanut butter, jelly, crackers, some multivitamins, canned fruits and vegetables,
mm-hmm.
and making sure that
Can opener.
You have a manual can opener. Mm-hmm. I think people forget that. Canned juices, milk and soup, and granola bars. But if you have, you're diabetic, have food allergies, you know, you need to adjust your menu accordingly.
Mm-hmm.
But store some plastic or metal cups, plates, spoons, and a knife, and some quick energy action and energy food such as hard candy and lollipops.
And one of my favorites, peanut butter, is a good energy food too.
Yes.
And it keeps fairly well even without refrigeration.
That's correct. And so basically you're preparing for three different groups of people.
Mm-hmm.
If you have an infant, and if you have a toddler into elementary school, and for adults, basically three different groups. Because the baby's going to need formula, diapers, bottles, powdered milk, medicine dropper, sting-free antiseptic, and perhaps infant pain reliever or fever reducer.
Right. Will the 81 milligram work for babies, too?
In terms of the
aspirin, something like that?
Having it in an infant form, such as that you buy at the store,
mm-hmm.
It's best to get that particular type. And then for toddlers into elementary, then you kind of transition into a medicine drop, having a medicine drop or mm-hmm. a liquid pain reliever appropriate to their
age
and, mm-hmm. and weight mm-hmm. as well. And then what works best are, of course, since some kids are picky eaters, getting some meat sticks that look like hot dogs. So I recommend something like bottled Gerber's meat sticks.
Okay.
And then some sting-free antiseptic in their favorite unopened cereal. And then adults also having, you know, some aspirin or a pain reliever, some anti-diarrhea medicine,
mm-hmm.
antacid, a small supply of prescription meds, their heart or high blood pressure meds, insulin if they're diabetic, their dentures or partials, contact lenses and supplies, an extra pair of glasses. And then generally for everybody, and you have to think of your, you know, personal sanitation, particularly if the power for water goes out, and that is being able to, you know, have a couple of plastic buckets with a tight lid and use plastic garbage bags with ties for, and of course the storing the toilet paper and the liquid soap and having the feminine supplies and so forth. Mm-hmm. One of the really important things I think that could be overlooked is having board and card games.
Something to do.
Something to do, especially with the kids, because they can just become plain restless.
Right.
When the power goes out.
Some other very practical suggestions here, including having a shut-off wrench, or what they call a monkey wrench, or a crescent wrench, something to turn off natural gas and water if need be. Pliers are really good to have.
Mm-hmm.
Some essentials, and again, this is stuff people obviously don't think about all the time. Tape is something you're probably going to need. Matches, you don't find many people have matches around anymore in a waterproof container, but you really need to have some around.
Right, that's correct. And a little lighter, it might not be able to reach too far, especially if you're trying to light the furnace. But
right.
So those types of things, aluminum foil, paper and pencil, a whistle, plastic sheeting, you know, something like 4 mil,
mm-hmm.
That you find at the store, and certainly having a flashlight and extra batteries, and a battery-operated radio with extra batteries.
I've got to mention here that if you look around, you can lots of times find a really decent price on a decent radio that operates on batteries and has the hand crank capability.
Right.
That is a good thing to have.
Right. And so, you know, radio, I'm a regular radio listener, so for me, it's very common.
Mm-hmm.
For other persons, it may not be so common, but it's radio really becomes essential in disaster preparedness. So
yeah, lots of times the TV stations and the internet sites are great when a storm is coming, or after a storm when some of the power is restored. But a lot of times it gets down to radio being the only one that's on the air that you can get. As the situation stands now, I mean, there are a few battery-powered computers out there, yes, but if your server, your provider is down, then you've got no service there.
That's correct, and of course, you need electricity. I mean, yes, you've got some battery power, you know, if you have a laptop or that type of thing, but again, yes, you've got to be prepared to go completely without the electricity to make all those things run.
Right.
So, and basically, for each person, you know, really preparing a simple first aid kit, you know, with some sterile adhesive bandages,
mm-hmm.
and towels, washcloths, scissors, tweezers, needle, moistened towelettes, and then a complete change of clothing and footwear per person, including a sturdy shoes and boots, hat and gloves, a blanket, and sunglasses.
Mm-hmm.
People might want to say, you know, why would I need to prepare sunglasses? But the bottom line is, even in snow, the sun comes out, and things are very, very bright.
Yeah,
so
good thing to have.
Now, if somebody says, you know, if you hear some type of person say, well, let the water run a trickle to keep the pipes from becoming frozen,
mm-hmm.
it is extremely important that basically what that should be like one drop every 3 seconds.
It doesn't mean a stream. It means drops.
It means drops, because mm-hmm. anything more than that, I mean, if you're on the public water system,
right.
everybody will be out of water on a public water system if they actually let the water run a trickle.
Mm-hmm.
So it's important that's one drop every 3 seconds. And so and basically, you want to make sure other people know how to shut off the water, gas, and electricity at the main switches.
Right. If you're injured or something, then other people in the family need to know. You need to have emergency utility phone numbers available to you. You might be limited in what part of the house you can go into, so you need to have probably some duplication on that.
Right, and basically, you know, the phone numbers for the utility companies, mm-hmm. they will be the communicators to emergency management that various vital services have been lost, mm-hmm. and then the preparations will be made to open shelters and that type of thing.
Yeah.
And so it's basically, you have to also prepare that, you know, to potentially leave your house.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to pick, and in general safety, I would say pick a couple of plan to pick a couple meeting spots outside mm-hmm. the house.
And choose an out-of-state friend or relative you can check in for everybody to call, right?
That's correct. You know, people worry. And so it's good to have a point of contact outside of the state, because the disaster may affect a wide swath, you know, here in Ohio.
Right.
And yet, so you need to have another point of contact outside. So in sort of getting ready for wintertime is, yeah. you know, you want to ask yourself, how's the chimney? Has it been cleaned within the past few years?
Mm-hmm.
Really important is having a carbon monoxide detector and
right.
ask yourself, how are the batteries?
Keep the batteries fresh. Same thing for the smoke detector.
Right, and ask yourself if the smoke detector is over 10 years old.
Okay.
Because the radioactive material inside the smoke detector actually degrades over the 10-year period, and then the detector doesn't work. So, and if you must use a fuel-based heater, store the fuel in a proper container outside, and remember to have ventilation when you use any fuel-based heater.
Right.
And use the carbon monoxide detector in the same room as the fuel-based heater.
Especially important to remember if we get into a power outage situation, because a lot of people will fire up that generator inside the garage with the door closed. Not a good idea.
And No. So, and it's also a good to not have it right up, smack up against the house as well, because the fumes will stay close to the house, and if you're cranking open a window for ventilation, and it's still a no-win situation. So you got to keep the generator, I'd say probably a good 20, 25 feet away from the house.
Mm-hmm.
And again, if you're going to use a shelter, and I would definitely say, you know, to encourage people to do so, because the Red Cross and the Medical Reserve Corps, that's what they plan, mm-hmm. you know, to do, is to open shelters and prepare for that. And and basically, you've got to put some things together before that, and that is, you know, a medication list with the list of meds that you're allergic to, as well as the immunizations you've had.
Okay.
And, you know, have written down, you know, your insurance policy names and numbers. Make sure you at least have a copy of your state ID, your Social Security card, or passport, a list of vital phone numbers. And what's really good to have is a copy of your durable power of attorney for health care or and financial matters.
Mm-hmm.
So it seems like a lot to prepare for, and I always try to make it simple for people to take one step at a time in preparation.
Yeah.
So.
This would be, are you going to post this on your website? This would
I
be
certainly can.
All right. The website is?
It is www.ashlandhealth.com.
Okay. And if people need more information, want to follow up, they can give you a call, right?
That's correct. And the phone number is 419-282-4295. Again, that's 419-282-4295.
All right, Ray, thank you for putting this list together for us and sharing it with us on the program today. It's good not only for winter and personal family safety, it's good year-round for things that can happen. And, of course, you know, we hope the worst doesn't happen, but you need to be prepared. That's the bottom line.
That's correct.
And, again, like you said earlier, as we open the program, don't let your pride get in the way of your safety. All right, Ray, that's our program for today, and thanks so much for being with us.
Okay.
You have been listening to Insight, a weekly in-depth perspective of important issues facing North Central Ohio. Listen again next weekend for another edition of Insight.